Hey, what's up, Knicks fam? Today, let's take a look at some of the defensive issues during our last game against Charlotte during that woeful stretch in the third, where we gave up our lead. It actually started in the final moments of the second when we still had a 12-point lead. After the defensive switch, Fournier ends up on Bridges. Now, we all know the hallmark of a Thibs defense is defending as a team, meaning help side has to be ready. So in this instance, Kemba is one pass away, RJ is the lowest defender, so he should be the help defender. Once RJ goes to help, Kemba will drop to cover RJ's man, Hayward, if the ball is swung to the corner. Then RJ can recover towards the wing. But RJ is too late and Fournier gives up a silly N1. In case you were wondering, this was a constant theme and RJ was made to look bad on defense on a number of possessions. Start of the third. The first thing we do is give up an N1 on Hayward. Now I don't know why RJ is sticking so close to Hayward here. Maybe he's anticipating pistol action being run at the wing, but Hayward hadn't made a 3 at that point in the game, so I don't know why he needed to stick so close to him. Of course, he gets beat on the back cut and no one was even close enough to help. He compounds the error by giving up a silly foul. On the very next defensive possession, again RJ is poor in getting back in transition. Hayward is his man and he seems to not notice until it's too late. Kemba has to pick up his man and Kemba is too small to do anything with Hayward so deep in the paint. Now on this next play, Bridges tries to set a brush screen and doesn't even make any contact, but RJ falls asleep and Hayward cuts unopposed to the hoop for an easy layup. Wait. So earlier he wants to hug Hayward at the 3-point line when he isn't really a threat. But when he's a threat cutting to the hoop, he's half a step behind.
What?
Well, to be fair, RJ is not entirely at fault here. It's really bad communication on defense. The correct thing to do here should be to call out a switch to blow up the cut. Both RJ and Randle can see the play developing. RJ knows he's behind the play and Randle can see the cut is happening. So either one can call out the switch. Well, nothing happens and Hayward gets probably the easiest basket of the game. He basically goes on a 7-1 run to cut it to a one possession game. Besides the lapses on defense, I'm genuinely concerned about Mitch. He had no bounce and was laboring up and down the court after tweaking his left ankle earlier on this play. Overall, he has not looked like his usual self. Not sure if his legs are struggling with the extra 15 to 20 pounds of muscle he put on during his rehab. Maybe Thibs needs to reduce his minutes. I'm kinda holding my breath every time he hits the deck. So there you have it. I think the starters can defend a whole lot better if they communicated better on defense. We don't really have the luxury of a lockdown defender, wait. Actually we do in Grimes and McBride, but I doubt Thibs will put rookies into the fire that easily. It's early days in the season and we have many games to clean up these lapses. Let's have faith they can do that. So what do you think? Drop me a comment down below, let me know. If you stayed till the end, know that I appreciate you. Like and subscribe for more future content. I'll see you in the next one. Let's go, Knicks!